Hello and welcome. On this video I'll show you how I made grass for my 3D game Omapeli. I'll be using Panda 3D, but this grassing technique works on any game engine. So let's get going. Historically, three techniques have been used to create grass in 3D games. The first is simply to texture your terrain with an image or a photo that shows the grass directly from above. Texturing generally requires vastly less processing power than creating the same amount of detail using an actual 3D geometry. But the camera rotations reveal the flatness of the 2D texture. The second technique, called grass cards, extends the idea of texturing to the third dimension. The grass cards are textured flat 3D objects that point up from the terrain. The difference here, compared to the lonely texturing, is that the grass is now depicted from its side and that the texture includes an alpha channel for transparency. These grass cards can be placed in a linear or a star arrangement, depending on whether the player can access the area or not. When using grass cards, you can sow tens or hundreds of grass blades in a single 4 vertices, 2 triangles mesh. The downside is that the immersion breaks down when looking these patches directly from above. But in many cases, this is only a mild sacrifice for greater performance. The final and the most straightforward technique is to create the 3D geometry for each and individual grass blade. This is the most resource-intensive technique, as each grass blade requires something from 3 to 10 vertices at least. Luckily, this is nothing that modern GPUs cannot handle. First, I set to create a single blade of grass using Python. A blade of 3 segments, for example, would consist of 7 vertices flat in the XZ plane. Then I added the mesh faces. 2 triangles per segment, except for the topmost segment that consists of 1 triangle. I didn't want the grass to stick straight, so I shifted the vertices along the y-axis. I think that gradual bending in this direction is the natural way how thin objects tend to bend. And here you can see the finished product. It looks pretty good to me, although the scale is wrong and double-sided rendering is not yet set on. Using Panda's wireframe rendering, you can see the triangles that form the blade. Well, it took then few iterations to get something exciting, but eventually I had a patch that looked nice. The patch here contains 1000 randomly generated blades. Next, it was just to spawn many identical patches in order to have a nice grass field. But on a hill like this, you can clearly see that something is wrong, as the patches do not follow the slope. One solution would be to deform the 3D meshes to match the terrain precisely, but I went for an easy and cheap technique. Each patch is given a pitch and roll rotation to match the slope. This works nicely, but you cannot have 2 sudden changes in your terrain, or then you have to keep your patch size relatively small. You could also add shear so the grass would point always upwards, but I left it for later here. The things were looking pretty good at this point, but spawning the exact same grass close to the player as well as far away from the player was not the cleverest idea. Luckily, Panda 3D has already an easy to use level of detail classes, the basic one just showing different 3D models based on the player's distance, and the deluxe also offering fade in, fade out for the transition. Creating the different detail level models went nicely since I had the grass blade model parametrized already. The patches further away would simply have less blades, and the blades in them would have fewer segments. And here you can see the system in its initial action. Notice how the patches far away have visibly less detail on them. Next, I did little optimization to see how much detail you would need further away from the player. For this, I removed the grass near the player so I could just focus on the grass on further away. And here is the outcome. This was the video about the grass creation technique for my game Omapeli. There are still few things to do to get the performance and aesthetics to the level I want, but I think I'll focus on other things next. My plan is to beautify the game still a little bit and then focus on the core gameplay loop and combat. Okay, if you made it this far, thanks for watching, and if there's anything, please leave a comment below. Until next time.